Self-Study Math Book 58. Basics of Division, 2 Digits Divisors. Let's start learning. As the grade goes up, are you worried about your child's math level? Do it with Self-Study Math. The developer of this educational program has coached elementary and secondary students in the field for over 20 years. And he has the experience of teaching teachers how to enhance the learning effect of students. In addition, he participated in a new learning textbook development project of a company specializing in education that provides educational services to students around the world from all over the world. Self-Study Math, a self-directed learning program specializing in elementary mathematics, developed by these experts, helps to strengthen your basic skills and enrich your application skills. The first step forward to improve your math levels. Whistle Education is with you. Self-Study Math is a self-directed arithmetic calculation learning program that induces complete learning through a systematic four-step program textbook composition of introduction, basic learning, intensive learning, and self-directed learning. In this course, you will complete the writing power of division with 2 digits divisors based on accumulating the mental calculation ability of division with a single digit divisor. First, through solving the problem of 2 digits divisors within less than 20, you will cultivate the writing power of division with 2 digits divisors. Second, through solving the problem of 2 digits divisors within less than 30, you will cultivate the writing power of division with 2 digits divisors. Third, through comprehensive learning of division with 2 digits divisors, you will complete the writing power of division with 2 digits divisors. Finally, through the process of creating and solving problems by yourself, you will develop problem-solving skills and complete learning. This textbook is designed to naturally discover rules and principles in the process of solving problems without learning the principles in advance. If you proceed with the method suggested by Self-Study Math, you will naturally discover the rules in the process of solving problems without anyone else helping you. However, you may not find the rules if you proceed the way you did it. In order to maximize the learning effect, we will inform you of the precautions that must be observed as follows. So please remember it before proceeding with the problem solving. First, don't try to solve the first problem right away as soon as you start solving it. Second, proceed with the learning method suggested by Self-Study Math. Third, if you do not finish solving the one-page problem within the given time, do not proceed to the next step. The steps to solve the problem suggested by Self-Study Math are as follows. First, before you start solving problems, you must first look at how the whole problem is structured. Second, look for what rules, patterns, are hiding. Third, once you have found a rule, apply it and start solving the problem. Fourth, if you have completed the problem solving without wrong answers within the given time, you may proceed to the next step. However, if you have not finished solving the problem within the given time, or if you have completed solving the problem within the given time but there are many incorrect answers, do not proceed to the next step. Try again until you can solve the problem within the given time. Hope you have good results. Problem solving begins now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Solve the problem until the next page appears. For reference, if you solve the problems without incorrect answers and writing solving process within the given time, basically, the writing power of division with 2 digits divisors, which is less than 20, has been cultivated. However, if the next page appears before solving the problem, Please try a little more. Perhaps you can find out some rules during the problem-solving process. Be sure to look for those rules. What kind of rules are there? Now then, shall we start? Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Did you solve the problems well? Did you ever look at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem? If you had looked at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem, you could have found that there are two types of problems, problems with no remainder and problems with remainder. If you have accumulated the mental calculation ability of division in the previous problem-solving process, maybe you could have solved most of the two digits divided by two digits problems without writing the solving process. Faithfully learn the problems presented in each course, and you will be able to solve the problems of the next course more quickly and accurately. Then shall we solve another problem? Problem solving begins now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Solve the problem until the next page appears. For reference. If you solve the problems without incorrect answers and writing solving process within the given time, basically, the writing power of division with two digits divisors, which is less than 30, has been cultivated. However, if the next page appears before solving the problem, please try a little more. Perhaps you can find out some rules during the problem-solving process. Be sure to look for those rules. What kind of rules are there? Now then, shall we start? Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 1 minute, it goes to the next page. Did you solve the problems well? Did you ever look at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem? If you had looked at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem, you may have noticed that each page divides a different dividend into a single divisor. If you have accumulated the mental calculation ability of division in the previous problem-solving process, maybe you could have solved most of the two digits divided by two digits problems without writing the solving process. Faithfully learn the problems presented in each course, and you will be able to solve the problems of the next course more quickly and accurately. Then shall we solve another problem? Problem solving begins now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Solve the problem until the next page appears. For reference, if you solve the problem without incorrect answers and writing solving process within the given time, basically, the writing power of the division with two digits divisor has been completed. However, if the next page appears before solving the problem, please try a little more. The 3 digits divided by 2 digits problem can be a little difficult, so I will explain how to solve the problem in advance. Now then, shall we start? How to solve vertical division problems. Step 1, compare the number of digits between dividend and divisor. For example, the dividend is 3 digits, the divisor is 2 digits. Step 2. Based on the number of digits identified in step 1, compare the size with the same number of digits in the dividend and divisor. For example, if the dividend is 3 digits and the divisor is 2 digits, compare the size of the 2 digits of the dividend, 2 digits consisting of 100s and 10s place number, and the size of the 2 digits of the divisor. Step 3. As the result of step 2 comparison, if the dividend is greater than the divisor, write the quotient for how many times the divisor enters and then calculate it in turn. If the dividend is less than the divisor, write the quotient and calculate how many times the 2-digit number enters within the 3-digit number. Step 4. Step 5. Step 6. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Start solving problems now. After 2 minutes, it goes to the next page. Did you solve the problems well? Have you ever looked at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem? If you had looked at the entire problem arrangement before solving the problem, you would have been able to figure out how to solve the problem right away. There were problems which you could find a pattern. Did you find it? If you solve the problem using the rules found in this way, the time required to solve the problem would have been much shorter, and it would have been possible to solve it easily. Right? However, Make it a habit to look at the entire problem composition before solving problems one by one. From now on, the problem of self-directed learning begins. Fill in the numbers in the given blank to create a problem and solve it. You can create a problem based on what you learned earlier. For reference, if you collect and organize the problems you are making, you can complete your own problem book that has only one in the world. Isn't it cool? Do not think that you create a problem by simply filling in the numbers in the given blank, but try to make it while thinking about what result will be produced, if you put a number in the given blank. Finally, if you use the given problem frame well, you can create any problem. In addition, you can even create creative problems to discover certain rules. Shall we create your own creative problem? Now then, shall we start? It is self-directed learning time. The procedure is as follows. First, create a problem using the given problem frame within 2 minutes. Second, pause the video and solve the created problem. Third, when the problem solving is finished, it is checked whether there were any errors in the problem creating process or the problem solving process. Fourth, correct errors that occurred during the process of creating or solving. Fifth, after correcting the error, it moves on to the next step. Now then, shall we start? From now on, the self-directed learning problem begins. Create a problem using the given problem frame for 2 minutes and solve it. So let's start. From now on, the self-directed learning problem begins. Create a problem using the given problem frame for 2 minutes and solve it. So let's start. From now on, the self-directed learning problem begins. Create a problem using the given problem frame for 2 minutes and solve it. So let's start. From now on, the self-directed learning problem begins. Create a problem using the given problem frame for 2 minutes and solve it. So let's start. From now on, the self-directed learning problem begins. Create a problem using the given problem frame for 2 minutes and solve it. So let's start. All problem solving is over. Thank you very much. Check again to see if this coursework has been done properly. If you have solved all the problems within the given time, move on to the next step. If not, you can learn again. If you feel that you are still lacking a lot, start over from the self-directed learning problems. If you haven't found the rules, take a full look again. For reference, if you find the rules hidden here, learning will be really easy in the future. Finally, share your own self-directed learning problems with other friends. And you will be able to help each other by comparing them with your own problems. Unauthorized premise, reproduction, or printing of this textbook is prohibited. Although it is possible to use it for personal purposes, please use it after obtaining permission from the copyright holder for commercial use for profit. The copyright of this textbook belongs to the individual who is the representative of Whistle Education. So if you wish to use this textbook for commercial purposes, please make sure to leave your contact information through email in advance and obtain permission from the copyright holder. After receiving the license, you can use it according to the contents and procedures of the permission received from the copyright holder. Thank you. Did you have a great time? When you feel that learning math operations is difficult, immediately find out self-study math. Good and subscriptions are always welcome. Please press it right now. Thank you.